learning under your next term, that is P-Proc, if you're learning. So I'll just show the certain mechanism where we'll be using this catalyst. Okay, so the first process will be considered as Leber's process. So reaction of nitrogen with hydrogen to convert into ammonia. Conversion of ammonia will be done with the process called as Leber's process. Here iron will be used as a catalyst and molybdenum will be used as a promoter. Iron is a catalyst, molybdenum is a promoter. Nowadays in industries, to move with this reaction, they are using iron oxide, potassium oxide, aluminium oxide as a catalyst also. Okay, so this is one application, Leber's process. Next application, that is known as Ostwald process. Ostwald process. So what is this process? Leber's process is the production of ammonia. Ostwald process is nothing but it is the production of your concentrated nitric acid, HNO3. Okay, so the production of HNO3 will be done by your Ostwald process. So here you will be using ammonia as a reactant. Oxidation of ammonia will be done to get nitric oxide as well as water molecule will be formed. 4, 4, 5, 6 balancing is important. So here as a catalyst an alloy will be used, alloy of platinum as well as rhodium. Okay, the mixture of these two will be considered as alloy. So these two metals will combine with one another so that this will be acting as a catalyst in the production of nitric acid. Maybe you are thinking production of nitric acid, but you did not get product as nitric acid. See, this having steps. Okay, production of nitric acid, as I said, you are going to study in P-Block. If you want, I will tell you now. So here the production of this nitric acid will be done. In first step, nitrous oxide formation will take place. Now again this will undergo for reaction. You are going to get nitrogen dioxide as a product. Again nitrogen dioxide, when it goes with oxidation in the presence of water molecule, you will get HNO3. So 3 steps procedure is very important at the P-Block lesson. But if you, in this lesson, if you learn application, you are learning, right? Catalyst where you are using, only the first reaction or first step you are using, where platinum as well as rhodium as a catalyst it will be used. Next example, that is contact process. Okay, so this contact process will go with the production of sulfuric acid. Here concentrated sulfuric acid will be produced by using all this process, contact process. How the production will be done? Sulfur dioxide, when it undergoes oxidation, to get sulfur trioxide. Okay, so this will be done either platinum as a catalyst or V2O5, which will be considered as vanadium pentoxide, with the certain temperature 480 degrees Celsius. So with the platinum or vanadium catalyst, you are going to get production of sulfuric acid. Again, here H2SO4 is not formed. Again, this is a 3-step procedure. Sulfur trioxide, again in next step, it will go and it will react with the some amount of sulfuric acid, H2SO4. SO3 plus H2SO4 to get oleum, that is H2S2O7 as a product. Again that H2S2O7, again on the reaction it produces sulfuric acid. Again 3-step procedure. But here where the catalyst will be used, you can write one is Leber's process, where the use of iron or potassium oxide or aluminium oxide will be used as a catalyst. Ostwald process, production of nitric acid, where in the first step platinum as well as rhodium will be used as a catalyst. These are nothing but alloy. Next, third one, contact process, where the production of sulfuric acid will be done. Here you are going to use either platinum or vanadium pentoxide. V2O5 will be used as a catalyst to produce your sulfuric acid. A simple example of your industrial application, vegetable oil, okay, or hydrogenation, it will convert into vegetable ghee, which is called as vanaspati. Oil to ghee, the conversion, how it will be done? In the presence of nickel catalyst, that is also industrial application. So in this, 4 applications are very important under catalyst term. Okay, so this is regarding your catalyst.